Good morning to all. Today we are going to learn about Indian rivers and water resources. This is chapter 5 from 10th class lesson, geography part, paper 1. Okay. Do you know that how much of water is used for domestic purpose? Yes. Only 5% is, about 5% of water is used for domestic purpose. And yet a large section of the population does not have access to the water. Means what? The water is not available for that large section of the group of people, because depending on the land and the resources, water resources. How many hectares of land in India is flood prone? Do you know that? 40 million hectares of land in India is flood prone. Means what it is? Flood prone area. Flood prone means what it is? Flood occurred areas. Similarly, large part of the country is also a drought prone area also. Understand? So one side it is flood prone, flood occurred areas, it's not useful for that people. But flood means what? More amount of water flowing on the ground, it's not useful for the some group of people. Similarly, some of the people don't have water. Lack of water situation means lack of rainfall. This situation is known as drought. Drought prone areas. They are living in the drought prone areas. What are the causes for this? Because according to that, the living geographical place or climatic conditions and altitude. So these are all causes of this. For example, some group of people, they are living in nearby the coastal area, they may be affected by floods. Understand? Some group of people, they are living in that, in India, mostly thar desert area, it is drought prone area only. Very less amount of rainfall recorded in that. The average rainfall also 150 millimeters only. Actually, the rainfall is measured in centimeters. So this kind of situations, account that location, account that place, account that latitudes. So these are all causes for that. Understood? Next, how much of percentage of outer surface of water resources are polluted? Exactly 70% of our surface water resources are polluted. How much of surface water resources are polluted? Why it is? 70% of surface water resources are polluted. Surface means what it is? Surface water flowing on the grounds or flowing on the earth surface. Why it is polluted 70%? So many reasons are there. Try to find out and think about this. Understand? Now, you will learn about drainage system of India. How many types and how many physiographic units are there? Okay. What is drainage? And what is drainage system? The flow of water through through well-defined channels is known as drainage. A network of such channels is known as drainage system. The drainage pattern of an area is a result of geographical time of period. The drainage pattern of an area is the result of the geological time period, nature and structure of rocks and topography and slope, etc. Understand? You can see this. Yes, this is drainage system. In India, about 77% of drainage area consisting of the Ganga, Brahmaputra, Mahanadi, Krishna, Godavari rivers is originated towards the Bay of Bengal. On the other hand, 23% of comprising the Indus and the Narmada, Tapati, Mahi and Periyar systems discharge their waters in the Arabian Sea. Means they joined in Arabian Sea. What is catchment area of the river? A river drain is a specific area which is known as the catchment area of the river. An area drained by a river and its tributaries is known as drainage basin. Okay, what is watershed area? The boundary line that line separating one drainage basin from other basin is called as watershed areas. The Indian drainage system is, there are three physiographic units. One is Himalayas, second one Peninsular Plateau region and Indo-Gangetic Plain. On the basis of its origin, drainage system in India is classified into two categories. One is Himalayan rivers and Peninsular rivers. Understand? And first we will discuss about Himalayan rivers. The Himalayan rivers belong to that three principal systems are there. What are that three principal systems? Mainly Indus River, Ganga and Brahmaputra. These three rivers you can remember easily. How do you remember? Simple code BIG. BIG means big. Big gane meer mind lo unchukochu. Himalayan rivers anagane three rivers vastayi. What are the three rivers? Big rivers. What are the big rivers? BIG. B means Brahmaputra, I means Indus, G means Ganga. Gurtunda? Yes. You can remind. And you can remember that easily. Next one. The rivers originate from almost the same region within few kilometers of each other, separated by water divides. Understand? Next one. Himalayan rivers and Brahmaputra rivers, these two rivers are developed at V-shaped valleys. Understand? The Himalayan rivers are also known as perennial rivers. Why it is called perennial rivers? This is because the rivers are supplied on the rainfall as well as the melting snow. It flow throughout the year only. Understand? It does not evaporate even in the during summer season also. Understand? Next one, Indus River system there. What is this Indus River system? The Indus originates in the northern slope of the Kailasha ranges in Tibetan plateau near Lake Manasarovar. Very, very important. It flows a northwesterly course through the Tibet. It enters in India, mainly in Jammu and Kashmir. Understand? Now, presently it is Ladakh area. The main tributaries of the Indus in India, there are Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias, Satluj. Understand? This, it covers that Jammu and Kashmir, Punjab, Himachal Pradesh. So these are the states. Understand? And next one, it is Ganga River system. The Ganga has twin sources there. What are these? The main one is Gangotri Glacier, which is also called as Bhagirathi. Understand? Another one is Satpanath Glacier. Satpanath Glacier, northwest of Badrinath, where is it is called Alakananda. Understand? These two rivers, Bhagirathi and Alakananda, these two rivers join at Devaprayaga to form a Ganga River. Understand? So these, from the onwards, that emerges from the hills of Haridwar. Right? The Ganga is joined by a large number of tributaries. Do you know what are that large number of tributaries of Ganga? Some of them called left bank tributaries, some of them called right bank tributaries. You can see here in this picture. What are the left bank tributaries? Easily remember that. And the code is there. 4GKM. 4GKM. Number 4GKM. 4 G's and 1 K and 1 M. What is this G's? 4 G's. Gandak, Ghagra, Gomati, and next K, Kosi, M means Mahi, and another one, right blank tributaries. What is this right bank tributaries? Yasoda, Vyasoda. Ya means Yamuna, so means Son, Da means Damodar. Okay, and some other rivers also there. Betwa, Son, Chambal. Okay, these are the rivers also there. The river Ganga flows through, observe in this map, which states there? Yes, Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Bihar, West Bengal, and after that Bangladesh. Okay, right. And next important one is, one see this system, tributaries of Indus River. Okay, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias, and Satluj River. Okay, it is in order only, right? Observe this. This is Ganga river system. Okay, observe that tributaries. We already discussed that. Left bank tributaries and right bank tributaries also there. What are that left bank? Means left flowing from left and flowing from right. See that? Yes. Okay. Observe this. Left bank tributaries and right bank tributaries of Ganga River. Okay. Right. So what was the kilometers? How much kilometers that Ganga River system occupied? 2,525 kilometers of area. It occupied the total land area 26.3%. Understand that Ganga River system also, that occupying area easily remember. How do you remember that? 25-25 means understood easily. 25-25 kilometers means what? It is 2,525 kilometers, right? Very good. We'll go to that next topic about Brahmaputra river system. You can see Brahmaputra originates from the Chamyongdong glacier of Kailasha ranges near the Manasarovar lake. In Tibet, the Brahmaputra is known as the Sangbo. Sangbo means the purifier. The Rango Sangbo is the major right bank tributary of the Brahmaputra in Tibet. The Brahmaputra river enters into India near the west of Sadia town in Arunachal Pradesh. You can remember that. Arunachal Pradesh. Ekkada enter avutundi Brahmaputra river in India lo? Arunachal Pradesh lo enter avutundi. Understand? Next, the left bank tributaries also there. What are that? Lohit, Dibang. It is also called as Dibang, Sikhang. Okay, Dihing and Dhansari and Bhuri. Okay, major right bank tributaries of Brahmaputra river is that Subansiri, Kameng, Manas and Sankosh. Okay, the Tista that joins the Brahmaputra on its right bank in the Bangladesh and forms here the river known as the Yamuna. Understand, Bangladesh lo dinni em cheptamante Yamuna river ga cheptam, not Yamuna, it is Jamuna. In Bangladesh the Brahmaputra river is known as Jamuna. Okay, observe this Brahmaputra river. Okay, see that మరి టిబెట్లో ఏం చెప్తాం బ్రహ్మపుత్ర రివర్ని? సాంగ్పో అని చెప్తాం. ఓకే, మరి ది నెక్స్ట్ వన్ అబ్జర్వ్ దట్ Where it enters in India? Yes, enters in India mainly southwest through Arunachal Pradesh in India. And first it's called Siang, and then as the Dihang. Dihang ane ekkadantamu, Dihang emerging into the Assam Valley. Understand? It is joined by two tributaries in that area. It's called Dibang and Lohit. Dibang and Lohit. From here, the river is known as Brahmaputra only. Understand? Brahmaputra River. See that here. You can also remember tributaries of Brahmaputra River. What are that? Simple code, Bhadradrilo Masita. Okay, you can guess it. What is this code? Right. Next, observe clearly the Ganga River finally joined in Bay of Bengal and through Bangladesh area only. And similarly, Brahmaputra River also joined finally in the Bay of Bengal through Bangladesh area. These two rivers, what are the two rivers? Ganga River and Brahmaputra River. These two merges in that Bangladesh area. At the place, it's called as the river water is known as Padma River. Understand? Ante Bangladesh lo ee rendu nadulu kalisinatvanti river water ni Padma River ga pilustam. And finally, it joined in Bay of Bengal. Understand? Right. Thank you. I hope you that you understood clearly about that Himalayan rivers. Understood? Now we will learn about peninsular river systems. The peninsular drainage system is older than the Himalayan rivers. Understand? The Mahanadi originates from Shihwa in Raipur district of Chhattisgarh and runs through Madhya Pradesh and Odisha and finally discharges its water into the Bay of Bengal. Discharges means what? Joins into the Bay of Bengal and merges into the Bay of Bengal. The total length of the Mahanadi is 851 kilometers. The popularly known as Dakshina Ganga. Which one is known as Dakshina Ganga? Yes, Godavari River. The river Godavari is the known as Dakshina Ganga. It is the largest peninsular river in this peninsular system. And it is the second largest river in India. So Ganga is the largest river in India. What is the length of river Godavari? Yes, 1465 kilometers. Where it is originates? Ekkada janminchindi? The Godavari originates from Nasik district of Maharashtra and discharges its water into Bay of Bengal. Antaloka water ni ekkada join chestundi? Finally in Bay of Bengal. How many kilometers length of Godavari? 1465, right. The Godavari covers the areas of Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. And some tributaries also there. Tributaries means sub rivers. It is also known as manam vitni upanadulu ani cheptam. What are the tributaries of Ganga? Pain Ganga, Indravati, Pranahita and Manjira. Okay. Next one is originating from Mahabaleshwar in Sahyadri, the Krishna is the second largest east flowing peninsula river. River Krishna. It is the second largest east flowing peninsular river in India. Which is the third largest river in India? Yes, it is Krishna River only. River Krishna. Where does originate that Krishna River? The Krishna River originates in that Mahabaleshwar.
మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి అండ్ ఫైనల్లీ క్లిక్ ఆన్ ది బెల్ ఐకాన్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
ఓకే, వాట్ ఆర్ ద ట్రిబ్యూటరీస్ ఆఫ్ మేజర్ ట్రిబ్యూటరీస్ ఆఫ్ కృష్ణా రివర్? కోయనా అండ్ తుంగభద్ర అండ్ భీమా. వన్స్ అగైన్, కోయనా, తుంగభద్ర అండ్ భీమా. సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద major tributaries of river Krishna. If we see this, total catchment area of Krishna River, 27% it lies in Maharashtra, 44% is in Karnataka and 29% in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana areas. Okay. The river Kaveri originates from Brahmagiri Hills, located in Kogadu district of Karnataka. Okay. And next, the river Kaveri, total length 770 kilometers. The major tributaries of Kaveri are Kabini, Bhavani and Amaravati. Do you know this? Amaravati is the capital of Andhra Pradesh, new capital of Andhra Pradesh. River Narmada originates from the western flank of Amarkantak Plateau. The Kaveri basin extends over the states of Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala, Union Territories of Pondicherry and finally draining area of this 81,000 square kilometers. The total length of Narmada River is 1312 kilometers. Narmada finally joins into the Arabian Sea in the Bharuch district of Gujarat. Originating from Multai. Where did this Narmada River originates from? Multai in the Bethula district of Madhya Pradesh. Tapi is the other important westward flowing river and joined into the Arabian Sea. Okay, about 79% of the Tapi river basin lies in Maharashtra area. Remaining Madhya Pradesh 15% and 6% in Gujarat area. Do you know that one and only river which flowing through Rajasthan? Yes, it is Luni River. Primarily, Luni originates in Pushkar Valley of the Aravali Ranges. Understand? Here it is in Rajasthan into two branches there. About that, Luni River, one is Saraswati and Sabarmati, which joined each other at Govindgarh. From here, the river is known as Luni. Okay? The Luni finally debouches into the Arabian Sea nearby the Rana of Kutch. Understand? Debouches means joins into the Arabian Sea nearby the Rana of Kutch. Understood?
మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి, అండ్ ఫైనల్లీ క్లిక్ ఆన్ ది బెల్ ఐకాన్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.